this is the shooter. You know, this is what we're trying to work on over here. This prototyping team for the shooter. We're a bit of a mess right now. This is early stages. This will get cleaned up. Don't worry about it. So we're thinking we want to have two flywheels. So we're going to have two sets of wheels, possibly driven by the same motor. That's yet to be determined. And we're going to have both of those shoot the cargo balls into the high goal, ideally. And that's all we're really prototyping over here. Right now, Ben's working on getting some hubs on some wheels so that we can put said wheels onto hex shaft so that we can spin them real fast. And then we got Piero over here working on a gearbox for a motor. We need that gearbox so that we can make things spin real fast. That's what we're doing here. We want things to spin. We want them to spin fast. We're going to have them spin. We're going to put a ball in the middle. And then it'll go, hopefully, into the bucket for 2 points. And then we also talked about getting game pieces into the exact spot we want them for the shooter mechanism. That way it's consistent and we can get it to be the same every time. It's consistent. Sorry. We had vaguely talked about making some kind of funnel, just a plate that is sloped and hopefully encourages the balls to go in one at a time into the shooting mechanism, really. And then at the bottom of that, we're going to have a narrow spot with a wheel just to index the balls and stop them from going in when you don't want to. The wheel is going to be run by a motor that we can turn on and off. When we turn it on, it just is going to shoot the ball into our shooter. And then we can hopefully score.
Okay. Clear. 3, 2, 1.
That one is under inflated, right?
Yes, it is.
After some initial testings, it looks like we're not shooting the ball high enough now. And we boiled it down to basically the compression ratio, so how much we're compressing the ball, and also how much mass on our shooters. So right now I'm going to try to increase the mass, as you can see how big of a difference that makes.
Adding a third wheel, I'm assuming.
Yeah, adding a third wheel, and I'm actually going to also add these smaller wheels in. Honestly, whatever else I can find here, like a bunch of these columns.
Sure. Connor, you killed Piero. No.
Oh my god.
We make sure safety is our number one priority here.
So basically, we're gonna probably try and use these wheels because they grip this tennis ball. Surprisingly well, and this is going to be this is a much smaller version of what the actual ball we'll be using is. So basically our first prototype when we get the big ball tomorrow morning is going to be putting these on there and just having this thing straight up. And then what we'll be doing is, if that can't do it, we're going to add a second set of wheels in the back that basically prevent the ball from what will likely be the failure case is slipping up like this.
Well, we are thinking about how we are going to have our intake placed onto the robot. The intake mechanism is going to be using this array of rollers powered by a motor and using the weight of this contraption itself to kind of compress and suck the ball in over our bumper and into a hopper that will be in this area. Our process right now, before we want to cut metal, is using a cardboard substitute for the pieces of metal we will be cutting and trying to figure out where we will need to drill holes for bearings and how many bearings we'll need and how much axle we'll need to cut, just so we don't waste materials later without having a plan.
Here we have our current CAD model. Rico and I have been working on it for the past couple of hours. We decided, in order to keep everyone on the same page, having a CAD model of the robot would be a very good idea, as people just kind of go off and do their own things and not have a coherent design and idea of what's going on. So Rico and I came up with this. We were able to find a chassis that matched our chassis on Andy Mark, I think. And from there, we've just been building off of what we need and what we expect the robot to look like. So you can see here, it's pretty simple. Things are as we had thought they would be for the most part. We have an intake, we have a hopper, we have a shooter up here. The idea right now is that this intake is going to be motorized along with the shooters here, and so that the ball will be sucked in by this intake arm, basically. Out here, it'll get grabbed by the rollies, the wheels, and it will get pushed up over the bumper here, and it will drop down into the hopper, where the ball will then roll into this position here. We have a little cutout, basically. Still need to work through some of the kinks here, but where it will hold this position until we want to shoot, in so that we can then spool up the shooter wheels here. And once we're ready, we have a cam shaft, or a cam down here connected to a servo, which is not currently assembled correctly. Anyway, that will then squeeze the ball up into the shooter, and the ball will then fly out at an incredibly fast speed, and we'll get like three pointers all the time. So easy.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, clear.
Oh, I think that's gonna work.
That's so clean.
Look at
that.
Here, wait. I'll hold this in place.
Oh yeah. I think that's gonna work.
So, actually,
do it again.
Yeah.
I mean, it's gonna have that inherent one
from the.
Because I'm
on
less rigid.
Yeah.
So
whatever this distance is, figure it out.
Oh wait, here. I'll hold this in place so it doesn't push against it.
So it's gotta be what, like, probably about 9 inches.
That's it.
Ready? Okay, so
needs to come in.
I mean, we can also have driving.
I'll keep it there?
Yeah, keep, no, well, yeah, I mean, keep the intake there.
Oh,
yeah,
sure.
We're still driving.
I feel like you can hold me a little bit, so that's probably my bad.
That's fine.
We're also going to be driving it while this is happening, right. So there's going to be extra forces and everything, so.
Very cool.
Now, I'll try and roll it in a line. That's so impressive.
Wow. It works.
I'm liking it a lot.
That's crazy.
Incredible.
Yes, good robot.
Woo! Someone sharky where we are.
So it's about 6 p.m. on Sunday. So far today, we've gone through a couple prototypes of our indexer design to get the balls actually into the thing. So what we're going to do is put this on a servo, and that's going to flick up. We tried that, and what we're going to end up doing is doing two going like this, because this one just wanted to push the ball backwards and wanted to go up. So there's that. We've modified our shooter so that it's wider now. It can actually mount onto the wider bars that we have down under the chassis.
It works. It just works.
And then the intake is getting mounted. We did a couple runs to like figure out where exactly on the uprights we wanted to put it. And they figured that out, so they're mounting that. So.
The rung that we're going to be attaching to is roughly 1.66 inches. I'm going to use this as a mock-up because I have it, which is just the handle of a toolbox. Our thinking right now is that we will attach the carabiner in a detachable fashion, say like Velcro or duct tape, to a metal arm that we'll be able to swing up when we are in that hab area. We could hold it just by like this area so that when we approach the rung, we can swing our arm down and like attach to the rung. The arm hopefully will then break away if we pull, leaving our hook behind, which will allow us to winch up the robot.
We talked about a couple things. We talked about climbing, and we talked about feeding game elements, balls, into our shooter mechanism. So climbing first. What we plan on doing is using a single winch system to hoist our robot up to the second
wrong.
Run, run's a good word. The second run. And to do a single pulley, or sorry, a single winch, while keeping our robot completely, or at least nearly level, that means one of two things. It means that we're either going to have to run multiple cables off of the same winch and have them at different points on the robot to balance it, which kind of looks like this, if you can tell what this is at all. Apologies, I'm not much of an artist. Ideally, we would have a winch, let's say at the back, it's arbitrary right now, and then you have two wires, and then they would move along a pulley system to turn 90 degrees, and then into another pulley to go up at 90 degrees, and that's where you would effectively have the weight held at these two side points here. That way it would keep the robot balanced, and it wouldn't tip. Conversely, you could also do it with one rope if you just put your winch right at your center of mass, then it's at the center of mass. So that's probably going to be really close to the center of our robot, which would be difficult if we only had two dimensions to work in, because then we wouldn't be able to get our game pieces into our shooter mechanism here. But because we have three dimensions, we can just put it above where the robot, or sorry, where the balls are going to want to move into the bottom of the shooter, and then below the actual firing arc. The ball is coming out of the shooting, and then it should be completely fine there, especially because we'll be able to keep the actual hook and the arm off to the side. The only thing we really care about is that the winch itself, which is holding the weight of the robot when it's climbing, is at the center of mass.
So, this is the elevator mechanism that we are going to use to deliver our timing hook to the mid-rung. We are thinking, because we're a little bit tight on space for our robot, we are thinking we are going to use a telescoping elevator system where there's a first stage and then a second stage inside that first stage. And when a rope is pulled, the bottom of the second stage will rise to the top of the first stage, and you essentially double your length, or your height, I suppose. So thinking about this, we have to keep in mind the minimum starting height that we can be at and our maximum height once, you know, we're fully extended, and the height that is required to reach that middle rung. So keeping all of those parameters in mind, and also thinking about if the robot tilts, trying to stay we've arrived at having the first stage be roughly 32.5 inches tall, the second stage being about 30 inches tall, with 5 inches of overlap between the stages and 2 inches of initial clearance for the second stage to poke out of the first stage so that we can attach our hook.
I hate you videoing me doing this. I don't want you to do this.